You are now watching the second part of our video on how to operate with the GDI set of Rayfinder dowsing L rods, including the power module. The link for the first part can be seen below. Please check the description of the video. Today we'll demonstrate a way to test the magnetic fields before start working on a new field, to determine the instances where nature or the environment do not permit a good search. Then we proceed going through triangulation scanning of an area and boxing method for target centering. Also, a technique to use a sample object as a bait in order to determine that the target has small quantity, like a gold nugget for example, or in cases of an object that has been recovered but still continues giving ghost signals. Thanks for watching this video. I believe it will be very helpful for all your dowsing adventures. Before starting on a new scan, it will be good to check the magnetic fields that occur from solar activity or other causes for this very moment and on this environment. That means, if magnetic fields are normal, good results can be obtained. If not, we may not attempt to search at all. Very easily, to test the magnetic fields, we use an iron or stainless steel rod that has to be fitted into the ground. And this is our example. What we look after here is to find out that our L rods will react to the iron object at a close distance. Let's have a try. Very well. Meaning that they have to cross, of course. When that happens, all will be great. As there is not any interference from intense solar activity or other magnetic field radiations. As we proceed for the next step, we do not need the stainless steel rod anymore. Here are the gold coins to be used as sample targets. Here we are. Just let them over the ground surface to practice. The safe way to go for novices is not to practice dowsing while walking around, as rod balance may be lost if you are inexperienced. Simply stay motionless and take two stationary readings at a distance of 30 meters apart. Then find the target spot by triangulation. Slowly rotate around yourself. The antennas will react to each other when over the target direction. Here I get a hit. Now, mark this direction and move 30 meters away and slowly again rotate around yourself. We have again a hit, and the rods react to the target direction. If I get out of the line, the rods will not react at all. Doing this, I have a rough idea that the target is near or far away according to the angle. I can now move towards the target direction, say 50 or 100 meters, and check again by performing another triangulation. When the target area has been narrowed down, I work towards that spot. When I pass behind the target, the antennas open up. Or if it is a strong attraction, rods rotate backwards. I give a little time for the antennas to react. I work towards the target, step over the target, the antennas open up. or if it is a strong attraction, they will point backwards. What we do here? Well, here we definitely mark the spot. We turn back and go the opposite way. The roads are crossed. I step over the target, I pass behind the target, and the antennas open up. Now again I mark the spot. What we have to do here is walk again crosswise. The antennas crossed, I step over the target, I pass behind the target, they open up, again I mark the spot. I turn and I go the opposite direction, just give a little time for the antennas to react. I step over the target, I pass behind the target, and the antennas open up, and I mark the spot. And what we have accomplished? There are four marks, 1, 2, 3, 4, when crossing the target from all the four directions. To find target depth, draw a circle from these marks. Circle radius minus the distance between rods and the ground surface, that is approximately 80 centimeters, equals target depth. On this example, the circle is quite small, as the target is shallow. If 80 centimeters are subtracted, we find zero depth. Our point here is to demonstrate a way to calculate depth for the completely novice dowser. What else? Sometimes the target is quite small. Could be natural gold particles or even a gold nugget. Sometimes an object that has been buried but has been recovered may continue giving a ghost signal. To test quantity, take a sample as this gold coin. To this point, a trick to create a stronger signal is to water our sub-target. Salt water is even better. Do not forget the soil has salts, and we want to duplicate the aging effect as we're chasing ions when dowsing. Here I position my bait target. I position it sideways, say 10 meters apart from the suspected target. I strongly suggest to water it well. Then stand between your bait and the suspected target. At this point, what I expect from the antennas? Let's see how the antennas react. I expect from the antennas to select and point to the stronger signal. That means the buried target has a stronger attraction. In other words, a larger mass compared to the sample.